A very good evening to all of you, dear viewers of Asia and Oceania. Welcome to one more program, Finding Answers. We would like to say a big thanks for those who are watching our programs faithfully and making the audience to be even better. Every Tuesday and Friday, we are holding our programs. You can share the link right now to all your contacts. As we will say, a very special prayer on your behalf by the end of this program. You can type now the comments about any problems you are going through. You can also send us the names of your family members, friends, and colleagues. We will include them all in our prayers. We will have plenty of good news of those who experience the power of God through our channel prayers, our Universal Church of the Kingdom of God and Succeed in Life Center are open 7 days a week, offering channel prayers, free counselings from the pastors, and definitely you'll be able to overcome any problems in your life. You can count on us. If you live in Japan, you can come and join us in Tokyo. Our address is Shinjuku Hyakunincho 2-23-43, close to Okubo Station, North Exit. If you are living any other part of Japan, we can send you the nearest address. You can call me on 080-3070-1661. Or you can visit our Facebook page, UNC Tokyo. Prepare yourself right now as we watch the testimonies. But before we enjoy the testimonies of faith, I just would like to remind you about one important matter. All of you, you are aware, during this week, we are in the purpose of 7 days of a continuous prayer. It means that we need to pray without ceasing. The Word of God teaches us that we should do it, like we gave the example of Peter in the Bible. When he was in prison, the church was united. The Universal Church of the Kingdom of God and the Succeeding Life Center, we are united. So please send the link right now to all your colleagues. And you can be sure that the prayer will be more effective tonight. Can you help us on this matter? You can send this link to all church members, those who are watching me from Hong Kong, Macau, Singapore, Japan. I would like for you to do it. Let's promote this special prayer. So let's do it right now to send the link and make many people to be connected with us throughout this week. Can you help us on this matter? Please share the link right now. And I believe we'll be able to cause such a great impact tonight. My dear viewers, tonight's question is, do you have a fixed or growth mindset? Do you have a fixed or growth mindset? You can type on the comments. How is your mindset? It's a fixed one or a growth mindset? Please, can you type on the comments and explain the reason why? We're going to watch the testimonies right now. We'll be right back with the answer.
Hi, my name is Amisha, and before I started Universal Church, I had severe depression and anxiety. I used to wake up in the middle of the night with these bad anxiety attacks, couldn't catch my breath, I couldn't focus in school. Depression, I was just saddened, so I couldn't find anything to make me happy. I didn't know what was the cause of it, it was just affecting my entire life. I couldn't really make friends and all that stuff. During my depression, many nights I used to cry myself to sleep, be alone, thinking, why is this happening to me? Is this happening to anyone else? Will this situation ever end? I had suicidal thoughts many times. I just couldn't handle it anymore. Everything in my life is just going downhill. After one day I was walking at the market, a member of Universal Church invited me to their service on Sunday. I went there, and that first service, I felt a great change. Like, it was something I couldn't explain. I used to attend the service Wednesdays, Fridays, and Sundays, and gradually everything started to fade. The way the depression began, I couldn't feel sad anymore. I was just happy all the time. I had fewer and fewer anxiety attacks. So at this point, I haven't had one like in about 5 months now. After attending the meetings, I was told by the pastor about the chain of prayer, and I started to attend Wednesdays, Fridays, and Sundays, the main services, and I put into practice what I was told, and I saw many changes in my life. No more depression, no more anxiety attack. And during my perseverance, I found peace. Amisha today is a completely different person. My life has been transformed in many ways. I'm at peace with myself, I'm happy, I'm completely delivered, I no longer have depression and anxiety, and God has done so much for me. My advice that I have to my fellow young people that are looking at my testimony right now and many other persons is that if you're in a situation like mine, if you've been through the things that I've been through, I just want to let you know that you're not alone. And if you're going through it right now, I advise you to go to the nearest Universal Church in your area and seek counseling with a pastor and explain your situation like I did to him, and believe, follow the steps that you're told, do what you're told, and your life will be transformed.
I almost gave up. But I didn't. My name is Dorothy Padua. I prayed for my son because he was rebellious. He's going to a wrong friends. He was a womanizer. At the age of 14, he doesn't want to go to school. He wants to live in a bird house. And he was stealing money to buy all his vices. I came to know the UCKG Help Center. I learned how to fight. I persevere. And now my son is not rebellious anymore. We have a good relationship. He gave up all his relationship. He study on his own. He has a good job, permanent job, and with high salary. And now he was totally transformed. I almost gave up. But I didn't. My name is Lorna Navarro, and I prayed for my mother, who was suffering from hypertension for many years and back pain, which was caused by an untreated injury when she was young. I learned to use my faith here in UCKG. I persevered. I continued to pray for her. And now, amazingly, my mother is well, my mother is happy, and she does not need any more to take strong pain relievers because the pain is gone. I thank God for honoring my faith and for healing my mother.
In life, there are problems that just hit you with a blow. Everything crumbles away and the heartache never seems to disappear. Everything keeps going wrong. You are in despair. What do you do when your hope isn't enough? When your single prayer seems to return unanswered and the persistent problem is still there? Partner with God and make a chain of prayer. The Chain of Prayer is a weekly series of uninterrupted prayer and action to tackle the most stubborn of problems. Make the chain of prayer and turn things around once and for all. Don't give up. Make a chain of prayer. It works.
That's the reason why the doors of the church are always open, because we truly believe that the church, the house of God, must be opened 7 days a week. If you see, Pastor, my day off is not on Sundays, so you can come to the church on Monday. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, or Saturday. Mainly, we have our main services on Sundays. But if there is no way for you to come, you can come any other day. We will hold special services during the week on your behalf. And let's do this special prayer every single day. We are walking around of the church. You can walk around of your house and be in the spirit of prayer. The Word of God says that we need to keep on praying. Throughout this week, don't just pray for yourself, but pray for the church. The whole church was in prayers, especially because of Peter's life, who was in prison. Probably you know that certain members of the church, they are going through problems. So throughout this week, mention the names of your friends in the church and determine that they'll be set free. We will unite our faith, by the way, tonight. That's the reason why we are insisting for you to share this link to all your contacts, to the other members of the church. Let's promote it. Let's do it faithfully. Let's cause this great impact in Asia and Oceania. You have family members abroad in America or Africa, Brazil, London. So please send the link now. We need to do something. We need to drag God's attention, especially this week. Let's break the routine. We will pray more. We will fast more. We will come to the house of God more. So let's do it. And definitely, God, He will bring a solution, not only to you, but to the whole church. Imagine it. Imagine when you come to the church on Sunday, and many people, they will say, I have got a testimony. I have experienced God's power. I was baptized with the Holy Spirit. The doors opened my life. I was healed. The sickness disappeared. The tumor disappeared. Imagine it. Plenty of good news. My dear viewers, it's possible. The church must be united, not scattered. So share the link right now, and I strongly believe something amazing will happen tonight. By the way, are you ready for tonight's question? Do you have a fixed or growth mindset? You can type on the comments about your answer. Please take a look on the screen. Fixed mindset. In a fixed mindset, people believe their basic qualities, like their intelligence or talent, are simply fixed traits. They spend their time documenting their intelligence or talent instead of developing them. They also believe that the talent alone develops success without an effort. Growth mindset. In a growth mindset, people believe that their most basic abilities can be developed through dedication and hard work. Brains and talent are just the starting point. This view creates a love of learning and resilience that is essential for great accomplishment. Basically, we can discern that God is looking for those with a growth mindset, because those with a fixed mindset, they are very limited. They just rely on their own intelligence and talent, and that they are not developing it. It means they don't listen to good advices. They are not trying to even develop or making any progress about their ideas. It means those who are fixed mindset, they are always limited. Or we can say, most of the time, they are negative. They cannot cross the limits of their lives. They cannot break the routine. But those who are growth mindset, you can be sure that amazing opportunities will come true in their lives. You will notice it, as the Bible says in the book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verse 8 and 9. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. In the story of Abraham, we see this truth clearly. A. Thought of Abraham, have a son and heir. B. Thought of God, make him the father of numerous nations. Now it becomes easy for us to understand why Isaac had to be sacrificed. Among the other reasons, we already know Isaac was the testimony of Abraham. But the offering of a sacrifice was necessary to realize the dream of God. When a person understands that he is being called to realize the dream of God, which is much greater than his, he must also understand that the level of charge increases. To conclude, a strong detail, Abraham did not have Isaac when Sarah gave birth to him, but when he sacrificed him on the altar. My dear viewers, that's the right answer. If you say, Pastor, I used to have a fixed mindset, so it's time for to exchange it and to have a growth mindset. To be able to understand that you can develop your skills, you can change your life. Plus, with God's direction, like what happened to Abraham, you will succeed in whatever you do. God doesn't want you for to have a fixed mindset, but He wants to have a large and a growth mindset so you can understand God's mindset. Can you understand it? That's the reason why tonight's question, I believe that it was an eye-opening to all of you, those who are watching me right now. Most of the time we see people with a fixed mindset. They don't understand God's will. They don't understand what God truly wants you to do with your life. He wants you to be blessed in different ways because He wants you to use your life. Abraham thought one way, but God's mentality was a different way. Even the Word of God says that God's ways were higher than the man's ways, and God's thoughts were higher than the earth. It means there is no comparison with God's mentality, God's mindset, with this fixed mindset. That's the reason why you need to ask for God's wisdom, so you may understand about God's mindset. My dear viewers, I believe it was such a great lesson to all of us, but still, we need to accomplish one more important matter. So share the link to all your colleagues right now. In just a few minutes, we will say a strong prayer on your behalf. We are living the spirit of the 7 days of a continuous prayer. So it's important for you to gather as many people possible to bind together this amazing miracle you wanted to achieve. Do you want to see miracles to happen? Do you want an angel to come to open the doors on your behalf, like what happened to Peter? So do your very best right now. Let's join as many people for the moment of the prayer. We'll be right back.
The UCKG Helpline Call Center is open 24 hours a day, every day of the week, all year round. If you need help due to a serious problem you may be going through, if you feel that you have nowhere to turn to and desperately need someone to lend a listening ear, then we can help you. It doesn't matter who you are or what you have done, your religion or race. Your call will be answered by someone who genuinely cares about you and have your best interests at heart. We also arrange home visits or the housebounds and hospital visits for anyone in great need of kindly human contact. Whether it is simply information you want or desperately need someone to talk to, we're here for you.
Let's talk to our Father. Heavenly Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus, as you can see that we have gathered as many people possible from different countries. because we are living this spirit of 7 days of a continuous prayer. My Lord, I ask you for to please answer our requests right now. We cannot accept, my Lord, this situation in our lives. And first of all, I pray for those, my Lord, who are suffering because of the fixed mindset they have, my Lord, developed in their lives. And they cannot see any good results because they are relying on their abilities, intelligence, and all their talents. But they are not improving it. They are not developing it. They cannot see any way out, my Lord, right now because of so many problems. Let them to exchange the fixed mindset with the growth mindset, because that's the way you can work on their behalf. That's the way, my Father, you can change their lives, the way that you have done with Abraham. You have showed Abraham, my Lord, telling him that he should count even the stars in heaven, on the sky, so, my Lord, he could understand God's plan. Let, my Father, this person to have a growth mindset, so, my Father, the Holy Spirit may work on their behalf, and their life should never be the same. You want, my Father, to perform wonders, not only in their lives, but in your own ways, my Lord, to bring glory to your mighty name in all the aspects of their lives, to show how great you are, how powerful you are. You want, my Father, to perform wonders, amazing miracles to those who believe in your mighty name. And we pray as well on behalf of those who are in the purpose, my Lord, during this week. We are praying without ceasing. We are praying at all times, my Lord, because like what happened to Peter, it must happen to us. My Lord, send this stronger angel on behalf of those who are watching us, those who are in this faith, to bring deliverance, healing, to bring, my Lord, protection. Do not let Satan to touch their lives anymore. It's forbidden. You are tied up, Satan. I rebuke you. Let, my Father, this prayer to be answered. We are praying, my Lord, every morning, afternoon, evening. And right now, this time, my Lord, we are breaking the routine so we can join ourselves from different countries, from different nationalities. So, my Father, you may answer this prayer. You may answer with power. You may answer, my Lord, to destroy the chains that are holding these people's lives back. I command you, spirits of hell, spirits of addiction, spirits of incurable diseases, let, my Lord, every curse, witchcraft, black magic, to be all broken tonight. Doesn't matter what kind of a pact was done with the devil, break it in the name of Jesus. I determine people's healing right now. There will be no more diseases on this body. Let this tumor, cancer to disappear. Let, my Lord, the brain damage, my Lord, to be now healed, restored. Let people's life should be transformed tonight. Let them to be set free from curses, from addictions, misery, poverty, those who are in the detention center, prison, hospitals, my Father, let them all to receive, my Lord, this power. Send your angels, my Lord, to those who are listening and watching this special prayer. I command you, Satan, listen to me. I command you, whatever you are, whatever you're planning to do, through the authority God gave to my life, I tie you up. I destroy your power. I command you, Satan, in the name of my Lord Jesus, get out. Father, I stretch out my hands in agreement of my Lord, many souls connected with us, newcomers, and even my Lord, church members, united in faith. You can touch right now on the screen of your device. By faith, let's bind your victory together. Let's bind this blessing. Be blessed tonight. Receive this answer. Receive this miracle. The miracle is happening tonight. The miracle is taking place tonight in your life. My Lord, we believe that whatever was impossible to a man, now it's possible because you are in control. You are guiding your people. We bless them. In the name of the Lord Jesus, receive God's light. Receive God's intelligence, God's wisdom. Receive right now God's vision so you may overcome these problems. We determine your success in Jesus' name. We believe all of you are blessed tonight. All of you, doesn't matter from which country you're watching us right now, be blessed. You'll be able to share your testimony in your local church. So receive this blessing. Take possession of this miracle in your life. We will continue praying more and more. That's the reason why it will be important for you to watch even the next program. The next program is called Breaking Chains. And the last one, it's called The Path of Success. My dear viewers, this week is the week of 7 days of continuous prayer. So don't give up. Every single day, get down on your knees, talk to God. Get down on your knees and present your situation to God. Don't forget to pray for the church. Don't forget to pray for the bishops and the pastors of the church. Are you praying for us? Are you sure? You can type on the comments, Pastor, I'm praying for you. So we thank you for the prayers, because we know that the prayers are blessing us as well. My dear viewers, be ready. We'll be back this coming Friday. God bless you. Have a wonderful night.
Uplifting. Diverse. Vibrant. Dynamic.
Powerful.
Youthful.
Informative.
Energizing.
Passionate.
Motivational.
Freedom.
Lively.
Excitement.